In this video, I'm going to walk you through adding a custom header to your Google Classroom. Sure, I can go to Select Theme and I can choose one of the stock photos that Google provides. But sometimes I want something that's just a little more festive, fun, and personalized. And that's what I'm going to walk you through today, is replacing this image from something that you've made yourself. Before we go into making our own, I do want to point out that no matter what we add in, this text will always be as an overlay on our image, and this text will always appear as an overlay. In addition, when we make our own, there's going to be like this dark, hazy overlay that comes over what we upload. So when you're making yours, try to choose bright, light colors. And you may have better results, and you'll see as we work through this. So we're going to begin in Google Drive, Waffle Menu, and from there, Google Drive. You could also type in drive.google.com. From there, go to the word Next, and choose the word More. When I hover over More, I see Google Drawings appear. Click on Google Drawings. Now, this does not match the shape of our header. So the first thing that we need to do after we give it a name, header for classroom, and hit enter, we need to change the size and shape of this. Because if we just upload a picture from the internet, chances are it's going to be skewed and stretched in our classroom header. So we're going to go to the word File, and we're going to go to Page Setup. From here, we're going to choose Custom in the drop-down menu. Now, we're not going to work in inches. We're going to work in pixels. So I want you to choose pixels from the drop-down menu and change these values to 1,000 by 250 and click Apply. And magically, we now have a workspace to create our header in. So here's a couple of basics for using Google Drawings. First thing is, let's change the background color by right-clicking. When I right-click, I can go to Background and I can change it. I think I'm going to choose this nice bright blue. Next, if I want to add a picture, I can go to Insert and Image. Now here I have some choices. I can upload something that I have saved on my computer. I can search the web. Let me give you a little quick overview of that. You can type in anything that you're looking for. Simply click on that image, click Insert, and Google will pop it on there. Or you can go to Insert Image, and you can even upload something from Drive. Now, I downloaded some Bitmojis and uploaded them into my Drive, and here I have one that I'd like to use. So to get rid of this emoji right here, I'm going to click on it and hit Backspace or Delete. Now, remember, there's going to be text here, so I think I'm going to pick this up and I'm going to move it over just a little bit so that that text isn't blocking the picture. And if I want to make this bigger or smaller, I can grab a corner. Now, that's nice, but how about we add some more? I'm going to choose Shape. So I click on this circle square, and I think I'm going to add a rectangle next to it. So I've got my target. I'm going to start where I want it to begin, drag, draw, and drop that shape. Now, that's an okay color, but I think I want it purple like this. So I'm going to click one time, make sure Google's looking at it, go to the paint can, and go to purple. Yeah, I think I like that better. Next, I want to add some text in here, and I want it to be big and bold, so I'm going to put it in as word art. I'm going to go to Insert, Word Art, and it tells me that I can type multiple lines by using Shift and Enter. So if you forget this little tip, it's right there. I'm going to put class meeting, Shift Enter, daily at 1 p.m. Now, to get it to appear, I simply hit Enter, and this now acts just like an image. I can resize it, I can drag and drop it. Now, purple on purple, not great. So let's make sure Google's looking at it. I'm going to click on it, go back to that paint can, and I'm going to choose white. Now the font, I think I want something a little more fun. So I'm going to make sure Google's looking at it, and I see the box. I'm going to go to my font menu and choose Chewy. And now I think I'll make it just a little bit bigger. This is also going to be a great place to post things like announcements. Remember, you could always add it as a text box. And in that text box, you can simply type, do bullet menus, office hours. You could do birthdays, special announcements, anything that you need. Okay. Now that I've shown you some of the basics, the final step is showing you how to download this in the correct format and then upload it into your classroom. It's really not that bad. We're going to go to the word file, download, and I like to choose PNG image. It's a little bit more clear than a JPEG. Either one of these will work. I like PNG. Now you'll see that it popped up down here as a download. Okay, it's on my computer in my downloads folder. I'm going to go back to Google Classroom and I'm going to click upload photo. From here, it says select a photo from your computer. Now I could pick this up and drag it right in, but I just want to show you that I can click on this and in downloads, header for classroom is right there, and I click enter. Now, I'm going to pick up this box, and because we had 1,000 pixels by 250 pixels, this is the correct size already. So I'm going to just drop this in, hit select class theme, and like magic, my image appears. I hope this is a fun way to personalize your classroom. And remember, when you want to change out information, you can simply go right back to that saved drawing and change what you need to change, re-download and re-upload. Have fun with it.